Have you no shame? Welcome to Unfiltered. I'm SE Cupp. That is what President Joe Biden asked Republicans who are backing a concerted effort to undermine our elections and our voting rights. It was back in July in a passionate speech on voting rights in Philadelphia. And throughout the speech, Biden was pointed. Quote, "We're facing the most significant test of our democracy since the Civil War," Biden said. "I'm not saying this to alarm you. I'm saying this because you should be alarmed," he said. And he went on, "Bullies and merchants of fear, peddlers of lies, are threatening the very foundation of our country." Now, in the months since, Biden and Congress have managed to do little about this pressing issue, despite the stakes being incredibly high. Neither the John Lewis Voting Rights Act nor the For the People Act, both meant to expand access to voting and to protect voting rights, have passed the Senate. And meanwhile, Republican state legislatures all over the country have passed dozens of restrictive new voting laws. So on this crucial issue, we're not only not making progress, we're going in the wrong direction. All the while, former President Donald Trump, his allies, and his supporters are conditioning the environment for the next election and future power grabs to come. Trump is trying to get reinstated on Twitter so he can continue to lie to an amplified audience. Former White House strategist and nationalist architect Steve Bannon recently warned of his plans to, quote, "take over the administrative state and deconstruct it when Republicans win in 2024. This time, we're going to be ready," he said. "We control the country. We've got to start acting like it," he said. "We're not going to have 4,000 shock troops ready to go. We're going to have 20,000 ready to go," he said. But actually, Democrats control the country, not Republicans. Democrats are in the majority in the House, the slim majority in the Senate. And obviously, there's a Democrat in the White House. So why are Republicans acting like they are in charge? Maybe it's because Biden is, well, floundering and ceding the most important issue to the GOP. Now, that issue isn't infrastructure. It isn't the debt ceiling. It isn't Kyrsten Sinema. It isn't even the filibuster or any of the other things we're obsessing over. The most important issue is neutralizing Donald Trump. The future of our Democratic Republic hangs in the balance and is quite literally determined by how much power Trump is allowed to grab again. The integrity of free and fair elections, it's the whole ballgame, folks. It's the whole damn Democratic experiment. If that collapses, as it nearly did on January 6th, and as some Republicans hope it will again, none of the issues, none of the policies that you care about, that I care about, will matter. Because if people don't believe that elections are real and have consequences, they won't vote. Legislatures and lawmakers will push more and more election lies. They'll decide this lawmaker is illegitimate and that one is. Suddenly laws are meaningless, and so is the Constitution. It isn't hard to see how this happens. Republicans and Trump loyalists are working on it right now. And yet you don't hear Biden talking much about Trump or the threats made by Steve Bannon or the whitewashing of January 6th by Mike Pence and other Republicans or about untethered GOP lawmakers like Madison Cawthorn and Marjorie Taylor Greene, who has attempted to impeach Biden several times. Biden hasn't mentioned QAnon very much either, despite the fact that it is now as popular in America as some major religions. 15% of Americans believe that patriots may have to resort to violence to restore the country's rightful order. This is the threat to our future. It is immediate. It isn't going away unless we decide to neutralize it. That means investigating and prosecuting Trump and his Justice Department. A new report from the Senate Judiciary Committee details just how seriously Trump and top DOJ lawyer attempted to overturn the 2020 election. It also means criminalizing, where possible, the spread of intentionally false information, deadly conspiracy theories, and the incitement of violent coups. It means serious consequences for lawyers and lawmakers who try to overturn legitimate elections and waste taxpayer dollars on phony audits and gimmicks. Biden and Democrats, meanwhile, seem to have blinders on. Back on January 3rd, Biden advisors explained their plan for dealing with Donald Trump in the future. Ignore him. Then January 6th happened. No one in the Trump administration, no one in Congress, has been charged with anything related to that day. Democrats in Congress are stymied over how many trillions to spend on infrastructure, but trust me, however Kyrsten Sinema votes on the Build Back Better bill, it won't mean a thing if Trump and his cronies get power back in 2022 and 2024. As much as Biden wants to move on, Trump and his allies are still the fight, because what they are planning is ominous. And with Biden's latest poll number at an abysmal 38% approval, according to Quinnipiac, Republicans are primed to bounce. So wake up, everybody. Feels a little like we're fiddling while America burns. That does it for me. See you next time.